Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Good Brothers YouTube channel. I'm Graeme, as you well know, but this is our new home at Winecraft. Don't worry about, we're not giving up on Good Brothers, it's still going strong. We just fancied a bit of a change of scenery. This is my wine corner. It's where you'll find me most days if you drop by and say hello. So please do, we are here. So today we are going to be talking about wines that we should be drinking right now, or that I'm drinking right now, and that are quite seasonal. And we're going to start with a Prosecco, but it's not like most other Proseccos. As we know from the previous sparkling video that we did at the beginning of this back in October, most Proseccos are made by the tank method, which means we secondary ferment in big stainless steel. This, however, is a Colfondo Prosecco from Cal de Lupe. So what is the difference? Quite simply, the second fermentation takes place in the bottle, like champagne, totally different from most Proseccos on the market. So what's the difference then? Quite simply, this has a more intense bubble, has more savory flavors, and there's no removal of the yeast. Okay, this means it's cloudy. So if you look at this, it's a cloudy Prosecco. And that cloudiness just adds more texture, more savouriness. It's a fantastic, fantastic wine. Let's have a look at it in the glass. It's also got this wonderful crown cap, which I can't get off. So, straight away on the nose, yes, it is Prosecco. We still get that lovely apple and pear and lemon coming, but there's also a savory undercurrent coming through, something a bit more vegetal, a bit more earthy in there. It's really great. It adds more texture, more depth to the wine. Oh, that's grippy. You've got some tannin coming through there. Still bright and still lively, a lovely lemon freshness, but beautifully savory. Absolutely brilliant. Cal de Lupe, brand new in, literally arrived this morning, and is just gorgeous. So what would we pair with this food-wise? You know what? It's a light aperitif-style wine. Olives, almonds, aperitivo styles, absolutely. But then if you're looking at something more substantial food, you want to look at sort of lovely, fresh asparagus. You want to look at maybe a little bit of seafood, some oily fish. Absolutely fantastic. Next up, we are staying in Italy and we are going up to Friuli, up in the very northeast, and we're looking at the Ribolla Gialla from Vicentini. Now, Vicentini is a fantastic family-owned domain. It is completely organic and biodynamic, certified as of last year as well. The Ribolla Gialla here is wonderfully light and fresh. If you're bored of Pinot Grigio, if you're bored of Sauvignon Blanc, Ribolla Gialla is a great alternative. It's fresh, it's lime, it's zesty, but it has a lovely little saline kick coming through that just freshens up and gives more texture to the wine. Absolutely lovely. It absolutely is bright in the glass. And is full of lovely, soft fruit, lively. Ah, oh, it's gorgeous. This is a seafood wine, absolutely. Shellfish, tuna, mackerel, anything with a little bit of oil in it, whitefish, butter, job's good. Third up, we're looking at Valpolicella. So staying in Italy, moving a little bit more inland towards Verona. And the Garagunda Valpol here is brilliant. Now, made from Corvina and Ronella, it's not like most other Valpols because it's a little bit lighter. You'll see from the color straight away when I pour this out, there's a brilliance of lightness. It's almost like a dark rosé in style. It's crunchy, it's got little green notes, green olive notes, but at the same time, lovely cherry, raspberry fruit, and lovely liquor tannin in there. This is brilliant, again, with cut charcuterie, saucisson, olives, almonds. But then if you're looking at a bit of griddled lamb, oh, fantastic, it really is. Savory, again, organic and bio, very little interaction here, human manipulation. It's very low in sulfur. It's just a well-made quality wine. Wine number four, we are going to France and we are going to the Loire Valley and specifically the domain of Guillon and their Bourgogne. This is all made on clay and limestone. It is organic and biodynamic, has been since 1965. This is a Cabernet Franc that is gorgeous. It's elegant, it's got great minerality, it's got dark fruit, but it's also got some light lifted sort of violets. It is brilliant. On the nose, just that sort of Palmer violets leaping out, great acidity, some slightly darker sort of cocoa notes and a little bit of leather, but absolutely wonderful. Great length, great structure, great wine, and this is brilliant. Toulouse sausage, typical rustic French fare, amazing. Chill it down, this will go with something like swordfish or tuna, amazing. So that was the Domaine Guillon Bourgogne from Loire Valley. These have been four wines which I love right now. Fantastic, they all suit different situations. Brilliant Col Fondo, Prosecco, savory. You've got the Ribolla Gialla, light, fresh, zippy white. Valpolicella, crunchy, still light. And then the Bourgogne here, lovely and savory and dark and got coconuts, amazing. So everyone, until next time, remember, drink better wine.